Hi, welcome back to another exciting video of Adventure Recap. Today I'm going to recap Journey 2 Mystic Island. It's a 2012 American 3D comedy, adventure, and fantasy film. Most importantly, it is the second film in the Journey film series. Journey 2 The Mysterious Island is based on Jules Verne's classic novel, The Mysterious Island. It's aimed at teenagers, and some of the giant creatures and some other scenes in it are too scary for younger children. It's fast-paced and also has plenty of good adventure elements, including action, fantasy, romance, and humor. The main theme of this movie is that love, friendship, and a caring family are worth more than all the wealth in the world. Values in this movie that you could reinforce with your children include family, love, and sacrifice. This movie could also give you a chance to talk with your children about real life's issues, such as the misleading way the movie portrays the consequences of Sean's reckless and life-endangering behavior at the start of the movie. You could also discuss the way his stepfather's relationship with police enables Sean to escape responsibility for his actions. Almost 4 years have passed after exploring the center of the Earth in the previous film. Sean Anderson has become a 17-year-old teenager. Sean was arrested by the cops for sneaking to the satellite control station a little later. Sean's stepfather, Hank Parsons, came to bail Sean out from jail. Hank discovers that Sean's received a coded distress signal from Sean's grandfather on a mysterious island that cannot be seen on the world map. Hank helps Sean to decode the stress signal. He takes 3 sheets of paper from Thayer, Jules Verne's books, and puts them together. A map of the mysterious island appeared on the paper. Hank and Sean immediately plan to go to the mysterious island, both to find Sean's grandfather and to explore the island. Hank, Sean, Gabato, and Kailani went to the mysterious island. This place is beautiful scenery, and the creatures here are also very strange. The four are chased by a giant neck lizard. Then they are saved by Alexander Anderson, Sean's grandfather, and also the father of two characters, Max and Trevor Anderson, in the previous film. So let's dive into the story. But before we start, don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to our channel to get some interesting stuff in upcoming videos. The movie started off very 90s style. 4 years have passed after discovering the center of the Earth in the previous film of the series. In the opening scene, we have got a rebellious kid on the run from cops. Sean Anderson has become a 17-year-old teenager. Sean was arrested by the police for sneaking to the satellite control station. A little later, Sean's stepfather, Hank Parsons, came to bail Sean out. This troubled teen gives his mother grief, doesn't get along with his stepfather, yada yada. Well, apparently he's in trouble because he broke into some satellite facility trying to get a better signal so that he could better hear the code that he thought he heard in his homemade ham radio. Next in the movie, we learn through an overly dramatic scene that the code was written in Vernian, what they call Jules Verne experts. And the boy decides the message has to be from his grandfather. Conveniently, his stepfather is an ex-Marine or something like that. So with his help, they're able to break the Vernian down to Morse code, interpret that, and find out that the mysterious island is real. And then through some more scenes of all-too-convenient deduction, they found out that the books of Treasure Island, Gulliver's Travels, and the Mysterious Island are all books about the same island. It's just the authors each only saw a third of the whole island. After that, using the book's individual island maps, Hank uses a backlight to make them a single island, complete with the coordinates to its location. Hank manages to convince his wife Liz to let him take Sean in search of the island to bond with him, but also slightly hoping to prove to Sean that there is no mysterious island there. After getting approval, they arrive at Palau, where Hank reluctantly hires helicopter tourism guide Gabato and his daughter Kailani, on whom Sean develops an immediate crush. He initially was vehemently refusing to participate in the trip, but quickly changed his mind after seeing Kailani to fly to the coordinates for $3,000, as they are the only ones willing to take them on their tour. After taking off, the helicopter gets caught in a cyclone, and they crash into the Pacific, waking up on the island. At first, the group is all shocked and awed by how beautiful the island is, and unlike the experience of James Cameron's movie Avatar, the audience is not really given a lot of time to drink in the beauty of the surroundings. Also on the island, things that are normally small are made larger than normal life, and the creatures that would normally be huge are now minimized. For example, an elephant is now no bigger than the size of a dog. But on the other side, a butterfly is about twice the size of a human. When they come across an egg clutch belonging to a vicious giant frilled lizard, Gabato accidentally wakes up the giant frilled mammal lizard, which chases them throughout the jungle on the warpath against them. They nearly get eaten by the lizard but are saved by Alexander. He then takes them to a hut he built from the wreckage of the ship that brought him to the island. He has a working radio, but due to the positioning of the satellite, it'll be 2 weeks before they can call out. The next morning, Alexander leads the group to the lost city of Atlantis, which he calculates resubmerges every 70 years for an extended period. When Hank feels seawater appearing from the ground, He concludes that the island will sink in next couple of days. Their only means of salvation seems to be the legendary Nautilus, Captain Nemo's submarine. Kailani enters Nemo's script and finds his journal, which shows that Nautilus is in a cave at Poseidon's cliffs. They decide to go there through the center of the island, as it's the quickest, but it's also the dangerous way to the other side of the island. To cross the mountainous island, they mount Giant Beast to fly over a high ridge and make up time. When Giant Bee-Eater birds try to devour them, Sean saves Kailani's life but dislocates his ankle. Hank and Alexander reset Sean's ankle, and then the group has a bonding moment when Hank sings his rendition of "What a Wonderful World" to ease Sean's pain. The next morning, the waters risen greatly, and Hank deduces that the island will sink in a matter of hours. Gabbato is missing, having gone toward the island's golden volcano in search of gold to give his daughter a better life. While Alexander and Kailani go after him, Sean and Hank head to Poseidon's cliffs. Sean also finally calls Hank by his preferred name rather than Henry, and the two fully bond. To reach Nautilus' underwater cave, Sean and Hank create makeshift oxygen tanks and dive down 50 feet, but are nearly killed by a giant electric moray eel. The 140-year-old batteries have run down, so they engineer a way to start the submarine with the eel's electricity. Kailani and Alexander find Gabbato and convince him to escape with them instead of trying for the golden volcano. As they near Poseidon's cliffs, the volcano violently erupts, creating lava flows and ejecting flaming lava bombs. Sean and Hank arrive in Nautilus just in time to rescue the others from the water. Gabbato pilots the submarine out of harm's way, while Hank and Sean fire torpedoes into the path of falling island debris. As he clears the dangers, Kailani kisses Sean for his bravery. 6 months later, Kailani and Gabbato are well off as he runs the most popular tourist attraction in Palau, tours aboard the Nautilus. Kailani visits Sean on his birthday. While the family celebrates, Alexander arrives with a book for Sean's birthday present. Jules Verne's From the Earth to the Moon, Alexander's suggestion for the next new adventure with the family. So in the end, they all make it home. Hutcherson gets the girl, the money situation for Guzman, and Hutchins all works out. And they all live happily ever after. Oh yeah, and there's hints of an upcoming sequel, which will probably be just as terrible and laughable as this one. Yay! This movie seems even more family-friendly than the previous movie. Younger children will be more excited and thrilled than scared. There's no intense violence in Journey to the Mysterious Island, but there's plenty of action and suspense laced with some light, playful humor. The movie eventually delivers a positive message celebrating family bonds. Also, there's no foul language or other crude content. The filmmakers and folks at Walden Media and Warner Brothers should be congratulated for keeping the series going by providing another entertaining, family-friendly entry. We hope you enjoyed our today's video. If you did like this video, smash the like button and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with the latest and interesting videos.